in the lab, doing stuff, making something. Fran, again, yada, yada, yada. And, you know, it's interesting. I don't know how timely this is going to be, but as of today, I've got just over 128,000 subscribers. And it's been on my mind recently, especially the last couple months, that I think that the size of the channel, as far as like subscribers and everything, is for me, it's like maxed out. I really don't want the channel to get any bigger. Not that I don't want to make more videos. Of course, I'm getting videos every week, but as far as like the audience for the channel, I really don't want the audience to get any bigger, because I've enjoyed the luxury of having the best of both worlds with a YouTube channel. My YouTube channel, by YouTube standards, is teeny tiny. Which means that the views tend to be a lot more people who are interested in the content I'm making, rather than like channels that have like a lot of views that are sort of it's kind of like the crowd that gathers around an accident, you know. the comments, I think when you have an audience that's a little more devoted to the content and actually interested in what you're doing, the comments tend to be more constructive, and the people who are watching the videos are tending to enjoy themselves more than not, rather than just being like a troll farm for people to come in and just say a bunch of nonsense and raise hell and all that stuff. Although the channel's small, I've gotten enough support to keep the lights on, and that's thanks to the people on Patreon, and it's because of the Patreon support that I don't have to run ridiculous ads. There are some channels that are running like ads every couple minutes, do like a 20-minute 30-minute video and have like 8 ads in there. It's like ridiculous. So I don't do the mid-roll ads, I don't do ads at the end, and all my ads are skippable, so I do the absolute minimum. And the only reason I run any ads at all is because YouTube requires it to share the videos, unless you've got like some kind of crazy like Facebook page with like 1 million subscribers or something. You can't get away with not having like any advertising, because YouTube just won't share those videos. I did found that out a couple years ago, when up until a couple years ago I was completely non-monetized, and my YouTube just stopped sharing all my videos and went through all that. So I run the minimum, absolute minimum of advertising. I'm able to do that because of Patreon support. And so, FranLab is doing pretty well. I don't know exactly where the Patreon is. It's probably over 80% funded, maybe close to 90% funded. It's getting close. The little bit of ad revenue, it's teeny tiny, but it kind of throws in a little bit on the top to kind of get me close. I've been shooting for like to get like 100% funded this year. It's almost there on the Patreon, almost. The way I look at it is this way: if I don't lose any patrons, or if I don't lose many patrons this year, but as long as I don't lose support, the channel doesn't have to be any bigger. And I would prefer my channel to stay in this size range, because there are enough people watching the videos to make it actually work like financially, that it can actually pay for itself. I don't want to make like a big profit on the YouTube thing. It really doesn't make much of a profit. Well, it doesn't really make any profit. But it's just a matter of just keeping everything going. And what I'm concerned with is if my channel were to be twice as big as it is now, I think it'd be unmanageable. I don't know if it'd be enjoyable, because even at like 128,000, I'm losing some of the sort of more cozy feel of the channel as far as like the audience is concerned. In the earlier days, the number of people who would readily comment on the videos, I kind of knew people by their you know, YouTube name. It's like, oh, it's so-and-so. Oh, it's that. Oh, hey, you know. And I would, so I, it was almost like having friends come by. But now, you know, the hundreds of comments on a video or thousands of comments, it gets impossible to have any kind of, like, real feel for, you know, who's making the comments or, you know, it's so, it's, it loses the coziness. So, you know, I don't know. I don't want it to end up being a job. I want it to be enjoyable, and I don't want this channel to become so big that it just becomes a headache, like if the comments get more and more swarmy. Smarmy. Swarmy? Smarmy? Smarmy. You know, I don't want to attract armies of trolls. It's just sort of 128K is just about the right size, and I'm sure that my old pal Bill Hurd would agree with that. Those of you who knew about the Commodore 128 know Bill Hurd. So anyway, I don't know. There's no way for me to stop the channel from getting bigger, even if I stopped making videos. Well, I've stopped. That's not going to happen because I have to work. But yeah, there's no way to like turn it off. You can't just. There's no option in YouTube to click a button saying I don't want any more subscribers. I'm just going to keep it where it is. Thank you. Just turn off the subscribe button and we'll just keep what we got. Can't do that. No option for that. So I don't know. It's kind of bittersweet. I know as I move forward, I got to keep making videos and stuff because I got to keep the lab going. But if I don't know. I wouldn't want to be one of those channels like Techmoan or, you know, EEV blog that have so many viewers that, you know, I can't imagine administrating those channels. I had to deal with that. I don't want that kind of attention. Actually, I don't even want this attention is the truth of it. I was very happy in the days when I used to have, you know, no subscribers and nobody on the planet knew who I was or what I did or what I looked like. I spent my whole adult life that way. Even in the Frantone days when I was, you know, those decades I was making pedals up until like 2010, 2011, nobody even knew what I looked like. There was no pictures of me on the Frantone website or even my name, you know, wasn't even on the Frantone website except for the Fran and Frantone. Nobody even really knew I existed. So I got very accustomed to, you know, living in the shadows and working in the shadows, and it's very hard, and it's been very hard for me to get used to the idea of being on camera and getting over a lot of my speech impediments, which I've really gotten a lot better at speaking on camera than I was in the old days. And I don't mumble as much, and when I look back on the older videos, sometimes I'm talking so quiet. I remember I used to have the microphone really close because I used to talk really quiet, and I'd have to have the microphone really close, and I used to talk like, you know, it'd be like this, but no, I know, but I sort of project a little more now. So now I'm projecting, move the mic further away. All that stuff. So I mean, I got used to doing these videos. So it's what I do. I think it's, you know, being a YouTuber is in many ways a very stupid job, but it is a job. It requires a lot of work, a lot of hours, a lot of dedication. It's an art and a science, editing, business stuff. You know, even administrating the YouTube channel, I spend, you know, a good 8 hours every day in the office, regardless, and administrating Fran Lab and taking care of the online presence and all the different feeds and everything. It's, you know, taking care of Patreon, thanking people, answering emails, questions, comments, all that stuff. You'd think that it would be, you know, like a nothing burger, but it's not. It is a absolutely a full-time plus job. to be sure. So, a stupid job, but it is a job. And I'm very thankful that I have a job, especially in these days. I'm extremely thankful I have a job. It's kind of like when I used to work in retail. It's the second to last assistant manager job that I had was at a video store, and I really loved that job. I didn't want to move on to another job, but they wouldn't let me keep my job. They said that I had to go to the special manager's training seminar. It was sort of like a Scientology or EST type thing, you know, where you had to like go away to this camp for like 2 weeks, and they would like train you to be a manager. It was some weird, you know, 70s sort of crap. But I said, no, I don't want to be a manager. I don't want to be salaried. I don't want to work 80 hours a week for somebody else, you know, at a store. I said, I like being assistant manager, and I like running, doing my 40-hour work week, and I like just, you know, getting paid on a salary. I said, well, if you don't become a manager, you got to leave because you can't be assistant manager. And they basically forced me out over like a course of a few months. But it's like kind of like that, you know. I didn't want to leave that job because, you know, the hours and the salary, it was, you know, and the job, it was all just right. I didn't want to move on. I didn't want to move up. You know, it didn't seem like getting bigger was moving up. It seemed like I'd be just giving my life away to a corporation for nothing. So I don't want Fran Lab to get so big that I won't enjoy it anymore. And I certainly don't want it to get so big that it just becomes a lot of hassle and pain and just a lot of people coming on the channel just to, you know, raise hell and be obnoxious and all that. I don't want that. You know, I like it the way it is. So, anyway, that's it. thanks for everybody who, you know, subscribed and, you know, you're part of that 128K. Thank you. I hope you enjoy the videos and hope you continue to enjoy the videos. And I hope that as the channel goes ahead that you, you know, stick around, and you know, I hope you don't feel that I get too big for my britches. That's never gonna happen. So, anyway, that's it. I'm Fran. It's another, I guess this ended up being a frant, but there you go. Thanks. And again, thanks everybody on the Patreon. You know, that's the only reason I'm doing this. It's true. So, you know, if you want to get on there and help me get to 100% funded this year, I'd like to do that. Just follow the link in the description. Go and patron. All right, that's it. I'm Fran. I'll be back here at the bench real soon. Bye! In the lab. That's where I work. Dessert. In my lab, it's where I work. At the bench again.